Hey all, and welcome back to another Clockify video. My name is Julian Griffin, and today we'll be covering timekeeping in Clockify. In this video, we'll cover all of the different ways you can track time and breaks, audit time, review, approve, and check to see which clients or tasks take up the most time. Let's go ahead and dive in. Clockify allows you to track time on multiple devices and platforms, on web, mobile, desktop, and via other browse extensions. Mobile and desktop apps allow you to track time even if you're temporarily offline. Your track time will be synced once you get back online. Mobile app allows you to track time via tracker, timesheet, and comes with extra features such as GPS tracking for on-the-go workers. The desktop app also has a tracker and comes with multiple advanced time tracking settings, including idle detection, reminders, and auto start and stop. Idle detection warns you if you've been inactive while your timer is running, so you can decide to keep the time or discard it. By default, time in Clockify is organized through tasks, projects, and clients, but you can customize these categories for your workflow. You can set the default week start and working days for everyone, and customize it for specific employees if needed. You can also set up a daily working capacity for each employee individually. Aside from those, you can set up specific reminders to notify members when they don't reach their targets. On the Clockify web, you can also import the time you've tracked in other apps as a CSV file, so you can easily continue with your timekeeping. Clockify also integrates with major productivity and project management apps, so you can track time directly within them. Or pick up a specific activity with a browser extension. All track time in Clockify can be submitted for approval, where managers or admins can review it before approving or rejecting. And for analyzing track time, Clockify has extensive timekeeping reports, summary, detailed, and weekly reports, helping you get insights from your time tracking data. You can even analyze changes made to time entries in the audit log report. Now, let's see how to use the time tracking features. The tracker has a timer and a manual mode. The timer also allows you to track time by simply starting and stopping the timer. If you switch to break mode, you can track your break time in the same way. Manual mode lets you enter start and stop times manually before saving the entry. Both modes have the same time entry fields, and some of which can be marked as required, so entries can be saved. More details can be added to time entries with custom time entry fields, which can also be required. You can prevent users from entering time manually or changing start and end times by enabling the forced timer option. The timesheet summarizes activities per project daily and weekly. Timesheets can be saved as templates and then easily implemented on other weeks. You can also copy last week's activities with one click and edit from there. Timesheets can be locked so employees can't edit them after the submission period. Kiosk allows for a quick clock in and clock out from a shared device. People can clock in with or without a PIN code, and the time will start ticking. Users can also switch from one task or project to another, and the clock break time in the same way. Kiosk can be active for a custom number of hours, so you can adjust it to meet your shifts and schedules. Besides tracking time via timer or manually, the desktop app also comes with an automatic time tracker. The auto tracker tracks activity on apps and websites, logging the time you spend on each. Recorded logs are visible only to you, and after you review your activity, you can transfer logs into time entries, after which they will be regularly visible in Clockify. You can customize the length of the activity for the auto tracker to pick it up, and hide items once they get added as entries.
If you found this video helpful, we have plenty more just like this one on our website, or you can just check us out on YouTube. That's all for now. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.